I'll start with, why did you change your philosophy? Why did you go out on a limb and say, gays are accepted in heaven? Something that the black church disagrees with.
Well, not only the black church, the church disagrees with it. And my gay friends, and I have several now, over the years, were some of the most sensitive, loving, creative, ingenious, generous people. Some are members of my family. I got tired of sending them to hell. It was the hell issue. They're going through it now, but these brilliant human beings spending eternity in a customized torture chamber, you know, it messed with my theology and my heart. And so I started preaching the gospel of inclusion, saying that Hindus, Muslims, Jews, everybody has access to the grace of the God we preach, and that not only a few Christians were going to heaven, and that's what got me in trouble with church. The devotion to the devil and hell is stronger or as strong as anybody's devotion to Jesus in many of the Christian circles.
We're going to talk more about that in a minute, okay, mm-hmm. and why this is such a taboo subject within the black church specifically. But Eddie Long, you're very good friends. He's sought your advice. He's sought your counsel a number of times. Did he reach out to you when all of this started happening?
I reached out to him. A couple of years ago, he embraced me. When he knew that I had been sort of castigated from the church, he walked up to me in Vegas at the Trumpet Awards and just embraced me and said, "Bishop, we didn't do you right."
Wow.
Now, that was a very powerful expression from him because no one else had said it that way.
Interesting for someone who's been very vocal about homosexuality and that it's not accepted and he's against gay marriage. So he came to you and said, "We didn't do you right." You came out and said, "I accept lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender."
Absolutely. Absolutely. I think in his heart, he does accept them. I think in all of our hearts, it's not kosher, if I could use that terminology, to accept them, because people like Ted Haggard, Ted couldn't have gotten where Ted got. He couldn't have grown and gone where he went in our Christian evangelical fundamentalist movement if he was gay. So he went as far as he went, and then they said, "Oh, no, you don't qualify any longer." He's still Ted. I know him. I think the kid was on my college wing at ORU. It grieves me that we treat people the way we do once we find out that they stop impersonating who they aren't. And the imposters are falling away. What would we do if Eddie Long really was involved in these relationships? And then what do we do? Do we throw him away? Do we castigate him? He's a prince of a preacher. He's really a prince of a person. He's a generous spirit. He's an incredible work in this city. Infidelity, adultery, that's a whole other subject. But if he did this, the question is, what would we do? The people rejoiced Sunday because he didn't admit to anything. They didn't want him to.
But that's what's interesting. He didn't admit to anything. There is a possibility. He said, "I am not a perfect man." But he did not come up to the pulpit and say, I am not gay. He didn't say those words. He didn't say these fears, these concerns that are coming forward, this talk about me specifically. It was vague. So and of course, these are all allegations at this point. What if he does come forward, Bishop, and say, "I told you I wasn't a perfect man, and I've been struggling with this issue," and he does say that he's gay? What if this story changes? How will you deal with that? Will you accept him? Will you embrace him? How would you counsel him as his friend?
Well, I would put my arms around him like he did me and say, "We will do you right." The scripture says if a brother or a person is overtaken or taken over by a fault, some translations say sin, you who are spiritual, not you who are critical or you who are religious, restore. The word katartizo in Greek means to repair, to adjust. If that's his case and he's been saying otherwise, then he's dealing with inner issues. Usually the people that speak the most vociferously against something are dealing with it in their own life. The one that's railing against drugs or drinking or sex or whatever, they're dealing. And it's not the issue of homosexuality, it's the issue of human sexuality. How do we deal with our sexual side, our sensual side, our spiritual side? Because they interplay, they interact. So it's wrong for, I'm not for Christian cannibalism, eating our dead or dying, destroying them the way we do so many people. we should, he should have been able to. In fact, before this got into the media and even to the courts, I wish the young men would have come to some of the apostles around the minister and confronted the bishop and said, let's deal with this. And then if he didn't, take it out to the courts. I wish we could gather around, and we will. If we find out this about that these allegations are true, those who really love the church and love Bishop will gather around him apostolically to embrace him and to let him talk to us. Who could he have spoken to if that was really his issue? What could he have said?
You've talked about this as well, the issue of being a black gay man, especially in the church, yeah, and a man within ministry, gospel music. There have been allegations that have come forward. There have been individuals that have come forward and said, I'm gay, and have been completely shut out of the black church because of that. Why is it so unacceptable to be a black man and to be gay and to lead a flock? Why is it so taboo?
Well, first of all,
it's not just biblical. I mean, there's a cultural
Of course.
Here.
Yeah, that's for white folks. See, y'all are supposed to do all that kind of stuff. We don't do that kind of stuff. we real men. I said that in jest, but that's
no,
an underlying.
No, but that's interesting. That's what's going on.
Yeah, we don't do weird stuff. Now, the other hypocritical aspect of that is our churches, Kira, are filled with same gender loving people, from the music department to the pulpits. Black music, church music, where would it be without our same gender loving or gay musicians and singers? Not all of them are.
But many of them have come to you and said, I'm gay, but I can't come
out.
Oh,
yes. Oh,
and we're
yeah.
talking very powerful people within
yes,
the gospel
ma'am.
Industry.
Yes,
I've met
ma'am.
Them.
Yes, ma'am. With tears in their eyes, they were afraid. There are people who've come to me and say, I embrace your gospel of inclusion, Bishop, but I can't. It's not a theological issue with me. It's a business decision. I'll lose my flock. I'll lose my money. I'll lose my parsons. I'll lose myself. I can't love everybody. I can't even love me, he would say. And I want to say to that group, and this is a wake-up call. Until the church, black or otherwise, confronts this issue of human sexuality and homosexuality, which is not going away. Homosexuals and homosexuality is not going away. If every gay person in our churches left, or those who have an orientation or a preference or an inclination or fantasy, if everyone left, we wouldn't have a church.
See, that's interesting.
Yeah, there are gay doctors, police officers, attorneys, priests. Look at the whole Catholic Church. All this idea of celibacy, it's not even natural. But it's out. It's like the Christian church is having to confront its issues. It's platonic, plastic, superficial portrayals of an angry God, a vicious God, an eternal place where everybody's going to burn, and this God with this terrible anger management problem who's going to get you, and then he's going to turn you over to the devil who's going to accuse you to him. And it's fairy tale stuff. But we bought into it, and now we're having to face the fact that maybe we missed it on many of these issues.
Well, this has definitely caught international attention, and he's a very powerful man of God, and he's brought up an issue that has been simmering for a very long time. And I tell you, as this story continues, because we know it's not going away, can we continue this dialogue? And
absolutely.
I would love to talk to you more as you counsel Bishop Eddie Long, and let's talk more about this.
Let me just tell you, Bishop Eddie Long is just the tip of the iceberg. I think the universe is not judging but correcting itself, and we're having to confront these issues. I love Bishop Long. I love anybody out there hurting, and I'll be here for them. And I love your tenderness in dealing with it. It's a delicate subject. I'm trying to be as discreet and tactful as I can, but it's an issue that's not going to go away. We got to deal with it. It's here for our help.
Well, I respect very much what you preach, so I look forward to talking to you more about this.
My
Bishop,
pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kira.
All right.
Thank you.